Hi all, this video is about principles of management. Here you can see the previous KUHS questions from this topic. Question number 1, enumerate 4 principles of management for mark. Second is a short essay, list down the principles of administration by Henry Fayol, 7 mark. Third is a short note, again principles of administration for 5 mark. And fourth is a long essay, define management, list down the principles of management and explain any one of them for 12 mark. This question can be asked as principles of management or principles of administration, but answer is the same. Further in this video, we will see how to write the answer for this question. To begin with, Henry Fayol is the author of Principles of Management or Principles of Administration. He is Henry Fayol. He was a French mining engineer and he is considered as the father of modern management. After writing about the author, list down the 14 principles of management, that is by Henry Fayol, or 14 principles of administration, whatever is the question. Here you can see 14 principles. Number 1, division of work, authority and responsibility. Number 2, 3, discipline. 4, unity of command. 5, unity of direction. 6, interest. 7, remuneration. 8, centralization. 9, scalar chain. 10, order. 11, equity. 12, stability of tenure. 13, initiative. And the 14, esprit de corps. Coming to the last of this video, we will see how these 14 principles can be remembered easily using a memorizing technique. The first principle is division of work. It means division of labor or specialization. What is the advantage of this principle? It allows the individual to build up his experience and to continuously improve his skills. Here you can see 6 members doing different kinds of job or task, or each worker has a specific task to do. If he continuously do his work, definitely his skill in performing this particular task will be improving. That is advantages of this principle, that is division of work or division of labor. The second principle is authority or responsibility. Otherwise, it is the principle of authority and responsibility. What is authority? It is a power of a manager to take decision, or it is a power of a manager to give directions or to give orders. What is responsibility? It means the obligation of the worker to complete the job assigned. In this image, you can see this is the manager and he is giving order, or he has the power to take decision and to give orders to the subordinate. This is the subordinate, this is the manager. He is the one giving order and so he has the authority. Then this is the subordinate. They have the responsibility, or they have the obligation, or they have the right to do whatever told by the manager. That is the responsibility. So authority is the power to take decision or give orders, and responsibility is the obligation to complete the duties assigned. Third principle is about discipline. What is discipline? They are general rules and regulation. If there is discipline, that leads to systematic working in an organization. This is an example of an organization where there is discipline. Here you can see systematic working environment. This is another organization where there is an orderly environment for each worker to perform his duties. This is an example of a typical indisciplined environment. Here you can see different workers are performing or behaving in their own way as he or she likes. So, discipline in an organization helps the members or workers to work systematically. The fourth principle is unity of command. It means the employee should receive orders from one boss or one superior only. This is an example of unity of command. This is the boss and this is the group of employee. So this group of employee should receive command or orders from this person only, not from any other person or not from other group of persons. Or he is this group of subordinate are directly responsible to this superior only, not to anybody else. That is called the unity of command. An employee or a group of employee should receive orders from one superior only, not from many superiors. If an employee receives command or orders from many superiors at the same time, it will create confusion and it will disrupt the systematic working environment in an organization. The fifth principle is unity of direction. What it means? All the efforts of the members and employees of the organization must be directed to one direction. Which is that direction? It is the achievement of common goal. Here you can see this fellow is confused. Why? Because there are different arrow mark in different direction. This is directed to this side, this is to this side, this is again to one direction, this is in another direction. So this fellow is confused and he don't know what to do or how to achieve the objective. Whereas in this picture you can see, though there are four members, they are all directed towards one goal. Or they are all directed towards one direction. So there is a common goal to achieve. That is what is meant by unity of direction. All the members or employees of the organization should be directed to achieve the common goal of the organization. Sixth principle is subordination of individual interest to general interest. What it means? The interest of the organization must supersede the interest of the individual. In this image you can see, in an organization there are several members working. And each one will have their own personal interest of performing a particular task. But each individual should subordinate or should surrender their interest to common interest. That is what you can see here. This individual have a personal interest, but he surrendered that interest to the common interest. Similarly, other persons also. Otherwise, in an organization, the general interest should supersede, or the general interest or the common interest should be given importance, not to the personal interest of the individuals. The seventh principle is principle of remuneration, or simply remuneration. It means employees must be paid fairly or adequately to give them maximum satisfaction. Adequate payment or salary gives satisfaction to the employees. You can see here, there are different employees or workers in an organization. They should be paid fairly according to their post or position or qualification. That will give maximum satisfaction to the employee. Eighth principle is centralization and decentralization. What is centralization? Here, the authority to make important decision is retained by the top level managers. What is decentralization? Here, the authority to make important decision is delegated to managers at all levels in the hierarchy. This is an example of centralization. See this picture. This is the top level management or top level manager. He takes important decision and that is conveyed to the subordinates. This is an example of decentralized organization. Here you can see three levels of managers or three levels of hierarchy. 1, 2, and 3. These are all at the same level of management or same level of hierarchy. He takes some decision and that is conveyed to his subordinate. He takes again decisions and conveyed to subordinate. He also participates in decision making and that is also told to his subordinate. Thus, the important decisions are delegated to the managers at the same levels in the hierarchy. That is decentralized organization. The ninth principle is called a scalar chain. It means the chain of superiors ranging from ultimate authority to the lowest. Here you can see A is the ultimate authority and this side E is the lowest authority or lowest employee. So this chain from A, B, C, D and ending at E is called a scalar chain. Similarly, on this side, A is the ultimate authority. Then we can see P, Q, R and S. So this chain is called another scalar chain. Then every order has to pass through this scalar chain, or the communication should occur in a scalar chain from highest authority to the lowest. For example, A, from A, the communication should pass to B, not directly to C. Similarly, from B to C, D, E, like that. So, from the communication from highest authority to the lowest is called a downward communication. And similarly, the communication from lowest authority should go to highest authority passing the scalar chain. So, this is called an upward communication. E, D, C, B, A, like that. Similarly, this side, downward communication and upward communication should follow the scalar chain. But in some cases, for convenience and urgency, a shortcut can be accepted. This shortcut is called a gangplank. In case of urgency or for convenience, D can communicate, for example, directly with the R, not otherwise. D should communicate with the E only. But in case of urgency, a shortcut of communication can be accepted, and that is called a gangplank. This is about scalar chain. The principle is principle of order. It refers to an orderly arrangement of men and material. Otherwise, there is a fixed place for everything and everyone in an organization. In this picture, you can see there is a place for brush. So in this place, no pencil cannot be placed. There's only this brush should be placed here. Similarly, this side for a scissor, there is a place. So this place, a pen or pencil cannot be placed. So a fixed place for everything and everyone is called a principle of order. 11th principle is principle of equity. It means fair and just treatment to employee. In this picture, you can see this worker is a male, this worker is a female, but a balance is maintained in their treatment. It means an employer or a manager should treat every employee in the organization irrespective of his age, sex, caste, creed, creation, etc. 12th principle is about stability of tenure of personnel. Stability of tenure of personnel means no frequent turnover or transfer in an organization. Look at this business enterprise. He says, I quit. Here also says same thing. He also says the same thing. So what happens here? There is frequent turnover. According to Henry Fayol, if this is any situation in an organization, that will not be successful. So he recommend stability of tenure of personnel. It means the job of a person or a worker in an organization should be stable. Then only that organization will become successful and attain its objectives. The 13th principle is initiative. Employees must be given the opportunity to take some initiative in making and expanding or executing a plan. Otherwise, an employee or every employee in an organization should be given a chance to take the first step in something and execute his plan. See this picture. This is one employee, this is another, like that many employees are here. So an employee is given a chance to take the first step or a step forward to begin something and execute his plan. Fayol says such an organization will definitely will be successful or it will grow forward. 14th and the last principle is esprit de corps. It means teamwork and it is fundamentally important to an organization. Fayol says work teams and extensive face-to-face verbal communication encourages teamwork. This is the picture of a teamwork. Here is a team of 10 members. So they have face-to-face communication. He is facing him, so there is face-to-face communication. Like that, every worker in this team have face-to-face communication. So this kind of communication encourages teamwork and easily the goals of an organization can be achieved. We have discussed all 14 principles of management given by Henry Fayol. Now, do you feel you can remember these principles easily? If you are confused or if you don't know the technique, here is the technique for you. That is the acronym to remember this principle. It is DAD, UC, USSR, OIC. The DAD, D, division of work, A, authority and responsibility, D, discipline. U for unity of command, C for centralization. Thus, DAD UC is complete. Next is USSR. U for unity of direction, S for scalar chain, the other S for stability of tenure, and R for remuneration. And this side OIC. O for order, I for initiative, S for subordination of individual interest to general interest, E for equity, and the last E for esprit de corps. Thus, you are able to remember, or you can remember, the 14 principles by this acronym. Thus, we have come to the end of this answer. First, again, summarizing how to write the answer. If it is asked as principles of management or principles of administration, the answer is the same. You have to begin your answer by mentioning few sentences about Henry Fayol because he is the author. Then after that, you have to draw the diagram by mentioning the 14 principles. For mentioning the principle, you can remember this acronym. Then describe about each principle in one or two sentences. Draw diagram if possible. Then at last, give a summary in one or two sentences. That is the end of this answer. Remember, the answer is the same even if it is principles of administration or principles of management. This video ends here. If you see it for the first time, please subscribe it. Also, share with your friends and support this channel maximum.